Hello friends, myself Dr. Nanda Kumar Rawbawale from College of Engineering Ambazogai is going to deal with Applied Thermodynamics 2. This is our 19th lecture. In previous lecture, we have discussed about heating and humidification process, then heating and dehumidification process, adiabatic mixing of two air streams, room sensible heat factor, grand sensible heat factor. Now today, we are going to discuss about functions of air conditioning, then classification of air conditioning. In that, we are going to discuss winter air conditioning system, summer air conditioning system, year-round air conditioning system, window air conditioning system, then split air conditioning system. Now, finally, we are going to study central air conditioning system. So now, functions of air conditioning. What is the function of air conditioning? What is meaning of air conditioning? So air conditioning is the system which maintains four things of air in a room or space to be air conditioned. So very first parameter the air conditioning system maintains is temperature of air. As per the requirement of the temperature of air to be conditioned or space to be conditioned, temperature of air is maintained by air conditioner. So here second thing is humidity of air. Depending on the requirement or the purpose for which air conditioning is used, the humidity of air is maintained. Then the purity of air. So as the air is circulated in the air conditioned space, so occupants may add some impurities. It may be a dust, dirt or smell. So that has to be removed, and purity of air has to be maintained. Say sometimes if it is used for a cinema theater, then the occupants, means the human beings, are going to liberate carbon dioxide by consuming oxygen present in the air. So that air has to be charged with the oxygen, as well as motion of air. As we know that the motion of air plays very important role. Simply if we have a fan in our room, so the velocity of air, it gets increased and we feel cool in summer season. So that is nothing but the motion of air is also plays important role in air conditioning. So depending on for what purpose air conditioning is used, so these four things are maintained. So if the space to be conditioned is for human comfort, then the humidity, temperature, then motion of air is specified in a particular range, and in that particular range the air conditioning system has to maintain these four parameters. Sometimes this air conditioning is required for industrial purpose. So in the industrial applications, the conditions of air are different, whereas sometimes this air conditioning may be used to store the grain. At that time, grain or fruits, the humidity and temperature, purity of air, motion of air plays a very important role in maintaining the grains or in the warehouses. So it depends what should be the temperature, what should be humidity, purity of air and motion on the application of air conditioning. Therefore, so this air conditioning system maintains these four parameters as per the requirement or application of air conditioning. Now coming to the classification of air conditioning. So very first classification is according to the purpose. So if it is used for human air comfort, then that is called as a comfort air conditioning. And sometimes air conditioning is used for industrial purpose, then it is called as a industrial air conditioning. Then according to season of the year. So in which season we want to use this air conditioning. That is winter air conditioning system, summer air conditioning system and year-round air conditioning system. So in winter we need more temperature and humidity of air, whereas in summer we need to maintain low humidity and low temperature of air. So year-round, so that kind of air conditioning system can be used in winter or summer. Then according to arrangement of equipment, that is unitary air conditioning system and central air conditioning system. Unitary air conditioning system means small units of air conditioner are made and those are fixed. So those have every system has got refrigeration system as well as other attachments, and that is known as a unitary air conditioning system. Whereas in case of central air conditioning system, so this refrigeration system or cooling system, as well as all other processes, are located in a room or a centralized place where the air is diverted or air is brought through the ducts. All the air from a space is diverted into the air conditioned system, and then the air is conditioned and it is recirculated into the room or space to be air conditioned. It is the example of what you say a cinema hall, where the centralized air conditioning system is used. Or else sometimes in case of big hotels, so centralized air conditioning system is used. So air conditioners which we use at our home are unitary air conditioning systems. So now we will go for winter air conditioning system. So what is this winter air conditioning system, and how this winter air conditioning system is used? So in winter air conditioning, the air is heated, which is generally accompanied by humidification process. So the air which is coming into this system is heated and also is humidified. So what are the components of this winter air conditioning system? So this, let us say, this is the space to be conditioned, air conditioned space. That means it may be a room, or it may be a cinema hall, or it may be something else. So here we want to maintain temperature, humidity and purity of air, as well as velocity of air in this space. So now we have here a fan for circulation of air, and here we can see first part is filter to remove the dust particle, dirt or anything else that is mixed up with the air. Then second one is a preheater. So air is in order to preheat the air, so this is one kind of heater. Then humidifier. So humidifier is nothing but the device which adds water particles into the air. And then reheater or a reheat coil, so which again maintains the drywall temperature of air. And here we have damper to get the outside air. So now this is the space to be air conditioned, and this fan blows out the conditioned air into the conditioned space, as well as the air which is excess, the air is recirculated again, which is to be conditioned, or where the temperature of air increases into the conditioned space. That air is circulated through this path, and then this air mixes with the outside air. So some part of outside air is also mixed with the air, and this mixed air is passed through the filter. So in this filter, the air is filtered, and from which the dust, dirt or other impurities or smell is removed. Then it comes to the preheater. So in this preheater, air is preheated so that humidification process can take place easily. So this preheated air enters into the humidifier, and here the water gets evaporated and mixes with the air. Then this air is passed through the reheat coil in order to increase its drywall temperature, to increase DBT to the required level. So this reheat coil is used. Again, this air which is having a required condition is blown through the fan or blower into the conditioned space. So in winter, we need high temperature or higher drywall temperature, because outside air temperature is lower, or drywall temperature is lower, surrounding drywall temperature is lower. At that time, we need to increase drywall temperature of room, as well as humidity of room. So in winter, humidity of air is going to be low. So here the humidifier and heater plays very important role to increase temperature as well as humidity of air, and this helps us to maintain purity of air. Filter helps us to maintain purity of air, whereas this blower helps us to maintain the velocity of air into the conditioned space. So this is what is known as the winter air conditioning system. Then coming to the summer air conditioning system. In summer, already the air is having more humidity, so humidity of air has to be reduced, so air has to be dehumidified and the temperature of air has to be reduced. So again here we have a fan, then here heating coil, then cooling coil and filter, and this is the space which is known as AC space, air conditioned space. Now the air from air conditioned space is recirculated similar to the winter air conditioning, and the outside air mixes. So this mixed air is passed through the filter. So when it is passed through the filter, again dust, dirt or smell is removed in this filter. Then this air comes to the cooling coil, where the cooling coil reduces temperature of air below the dew point temperature of air. So when this cooling coil reduces the temperature of air below dew point temperature, so cooling coil means it is a evaporator of refrigeration system. So when this air has got low temperature, that is the dew point temperature, below dew point temperature, so then it is passed through the perforated membrane or filter like part, where the condensed water particles are removed from this air. So as the temperature of air is below dew point temperature, so the water particles present in the air gets condensed, and those water particles are removed by the help of perforated membrane, and then this air is dehumidified. Then dehumidified air enters into the heating coil just to increase this temperature of air to the required temperature. So here it is very low temperature because of this cooling coil, which is the temperature below dew point temperature of air, and then it has to be increased to the comfort temperature range. So heating coil improves the drivable temperature of air, and when it becomes of the temperature of required or human comfort temperature, then this air is taken by fan and blown into the AC space. So this is the process again, processed air is passed. So the pure air enters from here, so through this damper, and the recirculated air mixes, and again this is recirculated. So in summer air conditioning, the air is dehumidified and cooled. So this is the cooling coil which is going to cool the air, and here the air gets dehumidified, and this water gets collected into the sump. Summer air conditioning. Now we are going to discuss the year round air conditioning system. So year round air conditioning system is nothing but the system which can be used in both seasons. It can be used in winter as well as summer air conditioning. So it has got both the facilities, that is to humidify or to dehumidify, as well as cooling and heating of air. So this is year round air conditioning system, in which this air is conditioned in both the ways, that is for winter and summer air conditioning. So here, say for example, we discuss about winter air conditioning. So recirculated air comes here, and the fresh air from outside get mixed, and the mixture of air is passed through the filter. So when it is passed through the filter, again dust, impurities are removed, and then the air comes into this cooling coil. In winter season, this cooling coil is made off, and then it comes into this humidifier. So water particles or steam is injected into the air, and air is humidified. So humidified air passed through the heating coil, where the temperature is increased, drivable temperature is increased. So the high temperature and low humidity, so dehumidified air is high temperature, as the heating coil heats the air to increase drivable temperature of air than the surrounding drivable temperature. Surrounding drivable temperature in winter is low. So again this air which is humidified and drivable temperature is increased is blown through this fan into the conditioned space. If it is a summer, then this air which is filtered passed through the cooling coil where the temperature of air is reduced below dew point temperature DPT. So when it is reduced below dew point temperature, the water particles from the air are going to get separated, and those water particles are drained from here. At that time humidifier is in off condition. So humidifier is in off condition, and automatically the water particles which are present in this air are going to be condensed, and those are removed by here perforated filter. So here that is not shown. Actually here perforated filter has to be shown, so that the air which is having condensed water particles are removed, and air is dehumidified, and then dehumidified air is again slightly heated in order to increase the temperature of air to the required comfort condition. So here dew point temperature is very very low temperature, which is not in the range of comfort zone. So therefore it is reheated in this heating coil, and this dehumidified and cooled air, so actual the temperature of air which is drivable temperature even after heating is lower than the surrounding temperature. In summer surrounding temperature is high, so this low temperature and low humidity air is circulated with the help of fan in the air conditioned space. So now we have unitary air conditioning systems. Unitary air conditioning system means, so separate refrigeration system is provided to the each of unit. So now this is window air conditioning, which is one of the unitary air conditioning system. So it has got two parts. One is outdoor part, which is going to be outside the room, and this part is going to be outside the room, and this part is going to be inside room. So this is the wall, that is nothing but in the window. Half of the air conditioner is kept outside the room, and half of the air conditioner is kept inside the room. So now here we can see we have here a heat exchanger, which is known as a condenser. So this is condenser, and this is capillary tube, and this is evaporator. Evaporator, and here we have filter. This is filter, and this is the blower, and this is the motor or common motor, which helps us to run this fan as well as this blower or inside fan. Now how this works that we see. So here the air from surrounding is taken by this fan, and which helps to cool this condenser. So condenser rejects heat and evaporator absorbs heat. So now first of all, this is the compressor. So the refrigerant which is compressed in this compressor is passed into the condenser. So when the refrigerant is passed into this compressor, so it has got high pressure and high temperature refrigerant, and that refrigerant comes into this condenser, where it is condensed and heat is rejected to the air which is circulated with the help of fan, and this fan is driven by motor. So this air which carries heat, and then the refrigerant is cooled, and high pressure is passed through the capillary tube. So when it is passed through the capillary tube, so this is capillary tube, small tube that is called as expansion device, then the refrigerant has got low pressure, low temperature, then it enters into the evaporator. So when it enters into the evaporator, so the this is the space room which is to be cooled, and from this room air is taken by this blower. So this blower is going to suck this air into it. So while passing this air through this evaporator, first this air is filtered with the help of this filter, and then it passes through the evaporator, where the heat of this air which is passed through the evaporator is given to the refrigerant. So then a refrigerant gets evaporated, and evaporated refrigerant, vapor refrigerant, again is taken by this compressor, and this compressor is going to compress, whereas this air which is cooled is circulated into the room which is to be air conditioned. So this is how this window air conditioning system works. So generally this window air conditioning system is used in winter. So if we change this direction of flow of refrigerant, then this evaporator can work as condenser, and this condenser can work as evaporator. At that time, this can be used in summer season also. So there are certain window air conditioners where such designs are made, where the condenser works as evaporator, evaporator works as a condenser in summer season. So similar project is also made by our students in college. You can see it in refrigeration RAC lab. That works in both directions. Once it throws the cold air and once it throws the hot air. So that is the purpose of window air conditioning system. So here in winter, in summer, if we are using this window air conditioner, so when this air is passed through this evaporator coil, so the temperature of air gets reduced and automatically the humidity of air is reduced as the water particles present in the air get condensed, and those water particles are removed from this window air conditioner. You can see in the window air conditioner, so water draining from window air conditioner in summer. So this is how window air conditioner works. In every air conditioning system, so this cooling system, that is compressor, condenser, expansion wall or capillary tube, as well as evaporator, is going to be present. So this system, without this system, air conditioner cannot work. So now next, moving to split air conditioning. So split air conditioning is similar to window air conditioner, but in this window air conditioner, so this is the single unit. Half of the unit is inside the room and half of the unit is outside the room. So but in case of split air conditioning, two units are prepared. One is indoor unit, so this is known as the indoor unit, and second is outdoor unit, so this is the outdoor unit. So these are the two separate units, and which can be placed at some distance. And here you need not to make a hole in large hole into the wall, only small hole to pass the tubings or to pass the refrigerant tube is sufficient here. So here you can see compressor. When the refrigerant is compressed in this compressor, high pressure, high temperature refrigerant moves into the condenser. When this fan blows the air over the condenser, so this heat is rejected to the surrounding, and then this refrigerant comes into this capillary where it is expanded. So low pressure, low temperature refrigerant moves into the evaporator, where the air is blown by the fan or blower over this evaporator, which gives its heat to the refrigerant. Refrigerant gets evaporated, and evaporated refrigerant or vapor refrigerant goes into the compressor. Again it is compressed. So this is the cycle going to happen, where the air is cooled in this indoor unit. So this indoor unit is placed into the inside a room, and outdoor unit is placed outside the room. So there can be a distance between indoor unit and outdoor unit. Only small holes of 1 inch to 2 inch is required to be made into the wall. So two holes are sufficient, or one hole to pass both the tubes. So this is the advantage of split air conditioning. So two units, indoor unit and outdoor unit, are separated. Therefore it is known as a split air conditioning system. Then coming to the central air conditioning system. So what is central air conditioning system? In case of indoor air conditioner or split air conditioner, for every air conditioner there should be a compressor, condenser, evaporator and capillary tube. But for central air conditioning system, there is a room or space or place where air is conditioned, and that air is circulated into the air conditioned room. Now you can see this is the air conditioned room. So where the temperature has to be maintained, humidity has to be maintained. Say for example, this is the cinema hall. So this is cinema hall. Now this AC system is placed outside this cinema hall somewhere, and it has got a compressor, then it has got a what we say, condenser. So this condenser is water cooled condenser. So this is the part known as water cooled condenser. Water cooled condenser in the sense it is heat exchanger. And then we have here the evaporator coil. Then here we have a filter inside. So here this is the cooling system and this is the heat rejection system. Now how this works, that we want to see. say the refrigerant is passed through this compressor, and compressor is going to compress this refrigerant, and then that refrigerant having high pressure, high temperature is passed into this condenser, where this condenser is circulated with the cold water. So cold water from cooling tower is passed into this condenser, and this cold water absorbs heat, it becomes hot. So this pump is helping us to pass this water. Cold water enters into this condenser, and from here this cold water becomes hot and it comes out. So hot water and cold water. So here there is a pump which helps us to circulate the water in this condenser. So in this condenser, when this water comes contact with the refrigerant, so not in direct contact, but in indirect contact, there heat exchange takes place, and the refrigerant is condensed, and then condensed refrigerant, but high pressure refrigerant is passed into this liquid line strainer, and then thermostatic expansion valve. So here there is a thermostatic expansion valve. So this refrigerant is expanded. When it is expanded, its temperature is going to fall. Low temperature, low pressure refrigerant enters into this evaporator coil, where the air from conditioned space is passed through this evaporator, and this air rejects its heat to this refrigerant. Refrigerant gets evaporated. Again, this refrigerant is taken by this compressor. Again, it is compressed, and same process is going to happen. So here the cooling effect is attained by air. So here this is the filter. So air is filtered, then it is cooled, and then this air is taken by this fan, and this fan passes this cold air, cold humidified or dehumidified or processed air, into the duct. Through this duct, this air is passed into the AC space, and it has got many more outlets which we call as a diffusers. Through these diffusers, air is circulated into the room. Again, when air is circulated into this room, this air becomes hot. So after that, the return air gets collected here, and this return air is taken into this AC system. Again, this return air gets mixed with some part of fresh air. So this fresh air is taken from this outside, and this fresh air is passed into this room. So some part of conditioned air and some part of fresh air to increase the oxygen level or the ingredients is mixed, and this air is again filtered, cooled, and then recirculated. So here, as I told you, the water is passed through this condenser in order to remove heat. So this water, when passes through the condenser, it becomes hot, and this hot water is passed into the cooling tower. So here it is spread in this cooling tower, and water is cooled. Then this water, cooled water, is again recirculated into this pump using this path. So this is the forward path, where the water is passed into the cooling tower, where water is spread in the form of fine particles in this cooling tower, and then this cooled water is again recirculated for the purpose of cooling of refrigerant. So this cooling tower is generally placed over the buildings in order to cool this water. So makeup water is added sometimes. So what happens here, this water which is spread into this cooling tower in presence of air, so air is circulated in this cooling tower, so some part of water gets evaporated, therefore the water deficiency takes place. So makeup water is added into this cooling tower. Whenever the level of water falls below the required level, then this makeup water is added into this system. Or else if there is a large water or some impurities are collected at the bottom of cooling tower, then this drain is used to remove these impurities. So this is known as a central air conditioning system, where the air is conditioned at one place, and then this is circulated with the help of duct into the air conditioned room. So there are more number of units for air conditioning. Only one unit of air conditioning is placed outside the room, and then the air is circulated through this air conditioned system and into the air conditioned room. So you can see one more block diagram of central air conditioning system. So here what is shown, you can see. So here this is cooling coil. So other compressor, in compressor, then filter, then evaporator, then expansion wall are not shown. So this cooling coil includes everything. Then heating coil, in case of winter, this heating coil helps. So this air is passed through the cooling coil in summer, and then it is supplied into this system through the diffuser duct and into this diffuser. So there are n number of diffusers which pass the air into the air conditioned space, and these are the return resistors, we can say here. So the air which is to be returned after use of that air, the air temperature increases, and when it needs to be again conditioned, so that air is taken out. So this return air comes here, and through this again the intake fresh air enters. So here pre-filter is there, then primary filter is there. So then this mixture of air is taken by this fan and passed through cooling coil or heating coil depending on the season. So again this supply air is passed into this room. So this is transition. So excess air is removed, or some air is intentionally removed from this in order to add fresh air into the system. So therefore this is known as a centralized air conditioning system, where the air conditioning is taking place in this space, and this air is recirculated into this air conditioning AC room. So this is AC room. So this is how the air conditioning system, centralized air conditioning system, works. So there are many more things to be studied into this air conditioning. So but as per your syllabus, we cannot move to the extent of complete air conditioning. So there is a heating load calculations and all, how the room adds heat and how to calculate or how to design the air conditioners, that is another part. So there are many more things that we cannot focus, we have to stick up with the syllabus. Therefore we conclude here for air conditioning as per your syllabus. Thank you.